Hello, you fine internet folks. I'm Brian. Welcome. Sit back, relax, grab your favorite beverage, and let's do some advice. Before I get started, I want to apologize for taking so long between posts. I've been super busy and just haven't had time to put together a video. I really enjoy the series, and I hope you are too, so hopefully in the future we'll have even more of these episodes. Let's get started. Our first letter is called, Am I a Jerk for Giving Bibles as Gifts? And this is from user Spread the Holy Word. I'm a Christian and proud of it. This year at Christmas, my friends and I all discussed gifts and decided that the gifts we would give each other should have a special, deep meaning. Some of my friends painted things or knit things, wrote poems or stories, bought a movie or a book or CD that meant something to each person. My relationship with the Lord is special and personal to me. I spent my free time reading Bible verses and finding verses that applied to each of my friends and wrote it in the front cover of their Bible, along with a personal message just telling them why I chose it, why I feel like it spoke to me in regards to them, thank them for being in my life. I had each of the Bibles monogrammed. They're gorgeous Bibles, burgundy bound with gold inscriptions and buttery soft pages. I'm not trying to convert anyone. They can throw the Bibles in a box in their attics if they want, but my religion is special to me, and in keeping with the theme of our gifts, I felt like it was suitable. As for me, from my friends, I received a beautiful set of crochet dish towels, a poem, a beautiful photo frame with the first photo of myself and that friend, a pair of handmade socks, and one of those mason jars with pasta and spices and sauce recipe, respectively from each of my friends. I love each present. But when my friends opened their Bibles, I saw obvious disappointment and even disdain on their faces. They aren't atheists or anything. Most of my friends have a wide variety of beliefs and consider themselves spiritual and agnostic. We have a religious-based discussion all the time, but I make sure I never, ever shove my beliefs down their throats. I support LGBTQ rights and I'm pro-life. This is supposed to be pro-choice. Not life. I mistyped due to distraction. Not that anyone will believe me. Am I a jerk for getting my friends Bibles for Christmas? Well, OP, I'm going to say that you're certainly misguided, and I think that you are a little bit of a jerk here. I'm not going to give you a super high number of points on the jerk scale, but this was still a pretty jerky thing to do. I'm maybe going to give you 1 out of 5, maybe 2 out of 5. Your friends and you discussed giving each other gifts that were special and meaningful. I think that you misunderstood the special and meaningful part of that. Giving someone a gift that they like is special. It shows the recipient that you understand them and know what they like. This isn't to say that the gift that you gave wasn't special or meaningful to someone, but not to your friends. If someone had given you a personalized Bible with some of your favorite verses bookmarked or written in the front, that would have been a great gift for you, but that would have been for you. The thing is that you could have given them a Bible along with another or personalized gift if you'd really wanted to go the Bible route. However, I think while you thought that this might be a meaningful gift for them, it really wasn't something that they wanted. You can't give people gifts that they don't want and then expect them to not be happy about it. It sounds like your friends put a lot of thought and interest into the gifts that they made for you. But then you, while you did put some thought into this, I'm not saying you didn't, this was more of a gift for yourself. You thought that this would be a great gift, but for you. You then go on to say they can throw the Bible in a box in their attic if they want. This makes it seem like you have some awareness that they wouldn't want the gift, and if you had really put that much time and energy into picking out this Bible, then you would be upset that someone actually didn't like it that much. And next, you talk about how your friends got you these amazing, thoughtful, handmade gifts, but then you gave them a, you know, mass-produced, highly reproducible book, while you did put some additional effort into it, like you wrote some verses in the front, and you certainly got them monogrammed, but that's not really the same thing as making something from scratch. Finally, you kind of end your letter defending your religious beliefs, and making it seem like the rejection of the Bibles is tantamount to a rejection of your beliefs. But the thing is that this wasn't an attack on your religion. This was simply a bad gift idea. Your friends would have probably acted similarly if you had given them some other gift that was not what they wanted, what they expected. And the thing is, like, again, you didn't give them a gift that they was special to them. You got a gift that was special to you. Well, anyhow, good luck with giving out gifts in the future, and hopefully you can do a better job of it. Our next letter is titled, Am I a Jerk for Telling My Ex-Husband He Cannot Send Photos to Our Daughter Through My Phone Anymore? And this is from Fairy Dust 4. I've been been divorced from my ex-husband for 3 years, and we share a 10-year-old daughter. He is remarried, and he and his wife share 2 young boys. The other day, I got a photo for my daughter from her dad. It was of the boys' room, saying they had finally put it together. They had just moved into the new house last year, and here was a sneak peek of it. I was infuriated because, to me, it was bragging, and I noticed my daughter's old toy storage unit in their room. I texted back angrily, saying how inconsiderate he was being showing her this. I actually didn't show her the photo. He also had to cancel Valentine's Day weekend with my daughter because he had to work and couldn't make the 3-hour drive to get our daughter. No, I'm not willing to meet closer or switch weekends, so don't suggest it. I did point out that missing Valentine's Day with her was awful because a girl needs her dad. He said he is working a bunch of overtime because they are taking her to Disney World this summer. Not my problem. I told him that he is buying her affections with Disney because he is missing weekends with her due to work. To my surprise, his wife responded, saying it wasn't him and that it was her who sent the photo. She said she had no intention of bragging and was just wanting to show our daughter, since she apparently was excited for her brother's new room to be finished because that would mean that her room was next. She also had to mention that it was her idea to take the kids to Disney. This was because I hadn't let her go with her dad several years ago during our separation. It's none of her business, and I had told her never to text photos to my phone again. Well, OP, I'm gonna have to give you at least 1 out of 5, and maybe 2 out of 5 on the jerk scale. The trouble is that I can't really make a firm assessment because I don't have a lot of details, and I think there's a lot of unknowns here. It sounds like you're on the defensive about your ex-husband. I don't think you handled the conversation as well as you could have. I think it was a little uncalled for you to attack your ex. I don't know what happened in your relationship, but I think you should make an attempt to at least be amicable for your daughter's sake. Now, I think that your ex-husband and his wife were potentially a little tone-deaf with sending the picture to your phone, but I'm not sure that they had malicious intentions, and it seems like they just wanted to show pictures to your daughter. It also seems like you might be the person who acts as a go-between between your ex-husband and your daughter when she's staying with you, and I'm not sure if they've sent pictures to you before or communicated through you before, and so that's a little bit of a confounding factor here, but I'm pretty sure that they have, and that's the way I'm interpreting this. Now, the thing that's hard to assess here is that I don't know whether or not your ex-husband is really trying to buy your daughter's affections. You paint him in a pretty negative light, and I'm not sure exactly how to interpret this. Now, you two are divorced for a reason, and I don't know that reason, but it sounds like you two have a lot of issues, and there's a lot of animosity between you. And it also sounds like you're not willing to work with him and to adapt for him. This may be a holdover from your relationship. Maybe he was uncooperative. Again, I understand that this situation might be really frustrating, that he wouldn't take the 3-hour trip. But again, I don't know if this is a 3-hour trip or a 6-hour round trip. In this particular case, maybe you two could have worked out having a bus trip for her or some kind of, you know, taxi system. I don't know. And I also think that you two should work out a little bit more of a direct line of communication between your ex-husband and your daughter. It seems like you acting as the go-between between them isn't working out, and it's going to cause a lot more frustration. It's going to continue to keep things raw for you, and I think that it's going to inhibit you from healing and working through your animosity towards your ex-husband. Anyhow, I hope that everything works out a little bit better for you in the future, and hopefully things are a little less frustrating for you. Our next letter is titled, Am I a Jerk for Using the Word Hot to Describe a Woman That I Work With and Making Her Uncomfortable? And this is from Hot Girl Dumb Guy. A couple of weeks ago, I, a 24-year-old male, went out to drinks with my 23-year-old female co-worker. While at the bar, she said she doesn't really feel like she fits in at our job. I told her that I felt similarly when I first started. Our job is mostly white men, and I'm not white, so I told her I felt out of place racially. We both talked about how that carried over into our personal lives. I told her that I felt like people of my race looked at me differently when they found out my job, and she said she felt like men looked at her differently when they found out what she does for a living. She said something along the lines of, guys either fetishize me and want me to roleplay, or they are intimidated and stop talking to me. She said she felt like she was never going to find love. I don't remember exactly what I said, but it was something along the lines of course you will. You're smart, strong, funny, and hot. I immediately saw her face change when I said hot, and I tried to clarify that I didn't mean it that way. She said that she thought we should go, and I agreed. She left before I did and avoided me for a while. She finally started to talk to me again yesterday. We were hanging out with a couple of the other guys, and we were talking about the new guy. I said he seemed cool and eager. The woman I went out with for drinks said, "But is he hot?" I asked her later if she was upset about what I said at the bar, and she said she wasn't mad at me, but she said she was uncomfortable with what I said and wanted to put me on the spot and make me feel uncomfortable with the other guys. She ended up saying, "Only jerks comment on a woman's appearance. Don't be a jerk." Am I a jerk? I don't really know why the word hot came out of my mouth. I wasn't trying to hit on her or put her in a weird spot. Well, OP, I think you already know the answer to this question, and it's pretty obvious that you think you're a jerk here because it seems that you're aware, or at least have some self-awareness that you might be a jerk here. Here's the thing, your coworker just got done saying that she didn't like to be fetishized, and then you went on and called her hot. It seems like she had all but said that she didn't appreciate having her appearance commented on, and this was in poor taste on your part. In the future, look at this as a lesson learned, look at this as an opportunity to control what you say, and, you know, move on from it. It's in a bit of an embarrassing situation. We all say embarrassing things from time to time, and at a certain point, you just have to realize that you've said something dumb and move on. Anyhow, good luck with your coworkers. Our next letter is titled, "Am I a Jerk for Making My Girlfriend a Delicious Romantic Dinner?" And this is from Lucky Luz. To preface this, I'd like to say that my girlfriend isn't a picky eater at all. She likes most of the food that I cook for her, as I'm the one who usually does the cooking since I love doing it. The one thing she doesn't like, though, is mushrooms. She picks them off of pizzas, pies, etc. She does order dishes with mushrooms in them when we go out. However, she just picks the pieces off and says that she likes the actual dish without the mushrooms on it, which I think is ridiculous. I mean, why order in the first place? But that's a different story. Anyways, fast forward to last night, it's our anniversary, and I wanted to cook something extra special for dinner. I found a recipe for this chicken dish that sounds absolutely divine. The problem is that it has mushrooms in it. I doubted that she would be able to taste them though, because the recipe calls for the mushrooms to be run through the food processor, so the pieces would be really, really tiny. And I don't think that she's able to pick off all of the mushrooms on the dishes that she orders in the restaurants, because I'm sure that they are too tiny, and she probably just eats them without noticing. We sit down to a beautiful dinner I made, and she asks what's in the dish and if it has mushrooms in it, because she can see bits and pieces. They were hardly visible, and they were incorporated in the sauce. I told her that it did contain mushrooms, but she needed to trust me, it'll taste amazing, and she'll hardly notice the mushrooms in the sauce. What's messed up is she refused to even taste it. I went through all that hard work, and you can't even see the mushrooms. The pieces are so tiny. She got upset and said she was sure that she wouldn't like it, and asked to be excused. When I went after her, she yelled at me and said I didn't care about her even when it was our anniversary. Of course I disagreed with her because I wanted to spend time with her and have a dinner with her because it was our anniversary. I wanted everything to be special, and she wouldn't even try what I made. Now she isn't responding to any of my texts. So Reddit, am I a jerk for making a special dinner on our anniversary, which my girlfriend completely refused to have an open mind and try? Well, OP, I think that you're gonna get a 4 out of 5 on the jerk scale here. The thing is that you knew that she didn't like mushrooms. You went out of your way to make a dish that had mushrooms in it, and then you are wondering why she didn't even want to try it? She said she doesn't like mushrooms, man. You can't just force someone to eat a dish that they don't like. And then your second mistake was that you made this dish on your anniversary. You didn't make any kind of alternative for her. You didn't try making some of the sauce without the mushrooms in it. I mean, there's so many things you could have done differently here. This was a bad idea. This was a horrible mistake. So the thing is this, you admittedly said that your girlfriend isn't a picky eater. She likes all kinds of foods, and the only thing that she dislikes are mushrooms. So you could have picked any other food in the entire world, but you chose to pick mushrooms. If you don't see why that's not a good thing, then you're completely blind here. The thing is that you have to listen to your partner. She knows what she likes, and just because she might eat an occasional mushroom here and there doesn't mean that she actually enjoys it. Trying to convince her on your anniversary that she likes mushrooms is certainly not the time or place to do that. In the future, what I would suggest is that if you really wanted to make a dish for your partner and you wanted to include mushrooms in it, then you should make one for yourself that has mushrooms in it and one for your partner that doesn't have mushrooms in it. That way both of you are happy and you don't have to deal with any kind of friction. You thought you were being sneaky by making a dish and that the mushrooms would be so finely chopped up that she wouldn't even notice it. What you probably don't realize is that she probably didn't just see the mushrooms in it, she probably also smelled the mushrooms. If she doesn't like the taste or smell of mushrooms, then she's probably sensitive to the flavor of mushrooms. Again, in the future, don't try something like this. Don't try forcing your girlfriend to eat mushrooms when she doesn't want mushrooms. Anyhow, good luck, and I hope that you can work things out with your girlfriend. Hopefully you can figure out a way to make this up to her. Maybe reschedule another anniversary dinner with her or something like that. Our last letter is called, Am I a Jerk for Not Wanting My Husband to Go on Vacation Without Me? And this is from One Ticket to Paradise. I'm pretty sure I'm the jerk here, and I was fine with admitting it to myself until a few of my family and friends told me that my husband was in the wrong. So now I'm just genuinely curious. Every year, my husband, a 32-year-old male, takes a few vacations, one of which being an annual vacation with friends from high school. Every year, he asks me, a 32-year-old female, if I want to go, and usually I say no because I can't get time off of work, and it's not a problem. It's nice to have some alone time for a few days. The vacations are also usually very active trips, like snowboarding, water skiing, or hiking, and they're all within the US. My husband knows that my dream vacation is one where I lie on a beach every day doing nothing, which I've never done. The group started planning this year's trip, and they're going to the Caribbean. They're going on an all-inclusive resort on some beautiful island where they're planning to unwind and at most go snorkeling. No talks of activities, just the sort of vacation I've been dreaming about. Husband thought I'd be excited for him. Spoiler alert, I wasn't. Here is where some of the backstory comes in that illustrates my jerkiness. My husband and I have very different relationships with money. He has a very high paying job, and I have a much lower paying job. I'm okay with it. I work enough that I can pay the bills, while having enough time and energy to pursue a personal dream. But I know I'll be working for the rest of my life. He has been saving to retire since he was 18, whereas I don't have a retirement account. He hates it. We've been to counseling about it. Anyway, the conversation goes a little like this. I don't get why you're so upset.
You're going on my dream vacation and I can't go because I can't get the time off.
You never mentioned specific name of island resort.
You're right. All I've said is I want to go and do nothing on a beach.
You couldn't even afford to go, even if you could get the time off. I mean, could you?
That's a little condescending.
Well, you said you didn't care if you had to work for the rest of your life, and we can't afford for both of us to go on this vacation. Do you not think I deserve this vacation?
Cue the seething rage. He turned the conversation into a big I told you so opportunity. Insult meet injury. The conversation ended with me telling him I had the right to be upset, and he called me a snotty little brat. Am I a jerk? Now, this actually has a bunch of edits with it, and I think that these actually clarify the whole situation a little bit better, so I'm gonna actually read these now. Edit. Wow, I was not expecting this. Thanks to everyone for your honesty. I want to clear up a few things here. I used the wrong word. A lot of you are saying that I chose to work as little as possible because I wrote, I work enough that I can blah blah blah. I don't pick and choose when I work. I have a full-time job where I am on my feet the entire time, and I also didn't choose to work a low-paying job. We live where we live because my husband's company relocated us. Unfortunately, I'm not a nurse, nor can I work in a shipyard. My opportunities are very limited here. I didn't tell my husband that he can't go on this trip. I won't tell him that. It's never been my place to tell him what he can and can't do, and I won't start now. And for those of you calling me jealous, you're absolutely right. I am jealous. Our finances. Oh boy, is this a fun thing to explain. Long story short, my husband grew up poor. Through his own personal therapy, he discovered that he needs money to feel stable in his life, which sounds like a, well, yeah, of course, but he puts it over his family, friends, and even his own happiness. He's been in relationships before where people whom he loves take advantage of his money, and he has always been very protective over his earnings. So we agreed to keep everything separate for his own comfort. I wanted to write a little something about my husband's job and how he contributes to my feelings surrounding this entire situation. As I said before, I work full-time and I'm on my feet all day. My husband has spent the last 2 years complaining about how all he does is sit and watch YouTube videos when he is done with his 15 minutes of work. No matter what job I've held during our relationship, we've moved a few times for his job. I've always worked myself to the bone only to make a fraction of what he makes for watching people build huts out of mud and sticks. Is it his fault? No. Is it irritating? Absolutely. My husband's job provides him with a company car, so he has no car payment. He also has the company's cell phone, so he has no cell phone payment. He doesn't pay for his car insurance, his gas, or his meals. It's all paid for by the company. And I think I'd be able to afford a lavish vacation if I didn't have all those things to pay for. But I do. And I pay for those things myself. I think that's all I wanted to add. Thanks. Alright, OP. You are not the jerk here. I'm going to give you probably a 0 out of 5 on the jerk scale here. But your husband, on the other hand, I'm going to give him a full 5 out of 5 because of how outrageous of a situation this is. First off, this is your dream vacation and it sounds like he is squirreling away money. It sounds like he could afford to take you with him if you really wanted to. You've moved a few times to help him further his career. This is a major factor as to why you're in the job that you are. Your husband is not being a very good partner, he is not helping you out, and in fact it sounds like he is hamstringing you and your financial well-being. And it's absurd that he would chastise you about your finances when you are earning so much less than him. It sounds like you are working hard and working a full-time job. He complains about getting bored at work, and this is a slap in the face. You two should be contributing what you can to the household. He is earning more, so he can afford to contribute more. You can still keep your finances separate, but he really should be helping you with your expenses as well. If you two were earning equal amounts of money, I could see dividing up everything 50-50. But in this case, and given that you have sacrificed your job prospects for him, I see this being a reasonable point of view. A reasonable way to tackle this situation is to decide a reasonable percentage for both of you to contribute to the household expenses. This includes your car payments and your cell phone bills. I have a lot of other questions here too. Does he make you pay half of the mortgage as well? Do you pay for half of the groceries? You say that he has food, but I mean, surely he has to eat at home every once in a while. With this attitude, he better be doing half of the household chores as well. Honestly, I'm not sure what is holding your marriage together at this point in time. Your husband sounds like a real piece of work. I hope that you can work out a better financial situation with your husband, but this might also be a situation where you want to cut and run and file for divorce. It really sounds like he's not being a very good partner at all, and he's not helping you at all, and you're sacrificing a lot for him. Anyhow, good luck, and I hope that things work out for the best for you. Alright folks, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, I'm sorry for the long delay between videos. It's really hard for me to get a video out. It takes me a lot of time and energy, so please be understanding. I might not be able to release them as frequently as I was in the past. I had a little less on my plate. So again, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you thought I did a good job, consider giving me a thumbs up. If you think I did a poor job, consider giving me a thumbs down. Anyhow, have a good day and take care.